Hi, I'm Chris. In this video, it's all about robot jog. I will show you how you can move your robot in the simulation in the most efficient way. Let's go. So I already prepared a little simulation. So if you go now to the program tab and select the robot, it will appear on the left side this program editor, on the right side this robot jog, where we'll focus on now. Make sure to be on the manipulation mode jog, because we don't want to move the robot in the 3D world. We want to jog it, and that's why I'm going to reset the simulation here. And now we will start with the axis specific jogging. If you click on one of the axes and drag it around, you are able to move the robot around, and you will see the slider on the right also follows this motion. So you can also use the slider to move the axis, and you can put in some specific values if you want to, where the robot will then directly jump to the position. If you want to reset the position of the robot, just click reset button on the top of your simulation window. You have a second option, which is the Cartesian jogging, where you can choose one of these arrows and drag them around in the view. The robot will follow, and if you go with your mouse on this little line, it will jump in 250 millimeter steps. If you go closer, it will jump in 100 millimeter steps, so a little smaller steps. You can also use this circle to actually turn and twist the robot flange as you want. And you can use this plane not to change the orientation of the flange, but just to move the robot in this specific plane. Just saw that I am in the world coordinate system. If I go to move, and if I turn the robot to plus 30 degrees and I go back to the jog, you will see that actually the coordinate system here is still in the world direction X, Y, and Z. But if I go on the parent mode, it will be shifted 30 degrees to the world coordinate system. And again, you can jog the robot around. In the object view, you have the same coordinate system, but in the view of the flange or TCP, where you can now twist and turn the flange as you wish. It's not the same as in the parent view, where you can actually just jog it around depending to the foot of the robot. And in the object mode, you can use it depending on the TCP. But you can always reset the simulation and move back to the initial position of the robot. You can also put in some values. If you want to go in X plus 100, you just type in plus 100 and it jumps forward. Same in Z, with plus 500, it goes up. Exactly. In addition to that, you have a third way of jogging the robot, is just pick this violet little circle or donut. And if you go on an object, it will directly snap on the position that you select. This is the same function as this snap button here. We only see the flange. And if you click, the whole robot will jump into this position. You can also set the position the robot should stand in at the beginning of the simulation. So if you just change the position, if you go to settings, save state, it will actually jump back into this simulation position. As soon as you move the robot and reset the button, it will go back into this pre-saved state.
Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to see more interesting videos about KUKA's simulation world, feel free to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.
Industrial intelligence.